Good evening, students. Already we met in the last week regarding the building services 2 of the electrical services and illumination concepts of electrical engineering in architecture department. Today, already we are knowing that electricity plays very important role for the development of any nation. In global advancement of nation directly depends upon advancement of electricity. Hence, electricity, it is mainly interposed with all activities of human being. You take communication, you take lighting purpose, you take heating purpose, you take transportation. One of the major sector now, diesel and petroleum products are depleting in few years. Hence, the transportation also mainly depends in future. In coming days, we expect more transportation depends upon electricity. In previous slide, we viewed that why the need of electricity. So now electric energy or electrical power becomes integral part of the human, or standardization of human depends upon development of electricity. If the sufficient quality and quantity of electricity is available, then there is a focus on the development of that country. It happens in developed countries. So, developed countries means it is not the question of richness, it is the question of reliable power availability and distribution of power for all 24 hours. Because some fields are there, power is needed for 24 hours. That fields you may name, agriculture is one, industry is one, lighting is one, and transportation is one. All these fields requires 24 hours of supply. It is only possible from developed countries. Hence, India is in developing country. And one more fact, the development of electricity activities keeps minimum fund. It is around 50% of the national fund is going to kept. Is kept for development of in electricity. So there are so many resources, energy resources. Later on we can see why the electricity only important. First thing, it is economical. It is economical. It is easily availability. Then transmission of electrical power with high efficiency. High efficiency, and it is not going to affect any environmental, and there is no production of smoke, there is no question of fire hazards. It is available in oil and solid materials. Getting the idea? Hence, there are many advantages which are uncomparable with electricity. We depend on development of electricity. Before going to the actual electricity, now we can view transmission, distribution, generation network. The power plants are installed nearer to the sources available. Sources availability, either it may be coal, either it may be nuclear, either it may be oil, different type of power plants are there. Those power plants are located at the nearer to the sources which are far away from the districts or load centers. After that, generated power voltage level is increased through the transformers. Through the transformers, 11 kV voltage is generated in the power plant. It is boosted to 220 kV or 440 kV as per depending upon design. Once the voltage of the AC power is boosted then it is transmitted to the load centers through the substations. In between, there is no distribution of electricity. After the transformer, which are available in substations, voltage level can be reduced to 22, 66 kV, 33 kV. Later on, it is again reduced to 33 kV to 11 kV. Those transformers are referred as step-down transformers. These step-down transformers are available in streets. We are taking the connection to the industry or houses through the service wires from secondary of distribution transformer. It is also known as step-down transformer. Very brief, later on we can see one by one. The electricity history starts from the electron, the word electron. That means in Greek civilization, amber means electron. The DC current, DC circuit is known as, it consists of DC voltage source, conductor and lamp. When the DC voltage source battery is having positive and negative terminal, through the wire conductor it is connected to lamp. When the circuit is closed, the flow of electrons will occurs. Usually electrons will flow from negative terminal to positive terminal through the lamp, hence shifting of electrons will occurs. Consequently, there is a flow of current occurs. Because DC voltage source is there, DC current will flow through the lamp, hence lamp is on. The electrons flow, it is absorbed from negative terminal to positive terminal, that is lower potential to higher potential. And conventional current will flow from higher potential to lower potential. Remember, electricity is analogous to water flow. How the water flow occurs? From higher level of ground to the lower level of ground. Just like river, water flow occurs from higher level of the ground to lower level of the ground. So current analogy is also same to the water analogy. Remember, electric current will flow from higher potential to lower potential. What do you mean by potential difference or voltage? Electric potential is known as, it is a charged body to do the electric work. The practical unit of electric potential is in volts. So similarly, if we are considering two charged bodies, then difference between the two charged bodies of their potentials is known as potential difference or electric voltage. There is always presence of stress and strain between two charged bodies, hence it always tries to balance. The flow of electrons will occurs, the flow of charge carrier occurs when the circuit becomes closed condition. Remember, again, potential difference is also expressed in volts. You go through the definition. It is the amount of work done to transfer the charge carriers from lower potential to higher potential. Next concept we can view, electromotive force. Electromotive force is a force or electric pressure. It is generally referred as sources available of potential difference, charged bodies. It may be battery, or it may be generator, it may be DC generator, it may be AC generator. All are referred as voltage sources. It is specified by volts, 100 volts, 10 volts, 2 volts. If I specifying 10 volts battery, as shown in figure, it has a charge, it has a electric force to do the work, to create a charge carriers in a given closed circuit. That means voltage sources are ready. If the circuit is connected, then the charge, flow of charge carriers occurs, conventional current will occurs. So electromotive force is a force or electric pressure. Generally it is referred as voltage sources. Consider a battery as shown in figure. It is connected to lamp, hence it is forms a closed condition. Then it will create the flow of charge carriers. Electrons will start drifting from negative potential to the lamp to positive terminal, which forms a closed electric circuit. Hence the flow of electrons will occur. Consequently, opposite to this one, conventional current will flow from positive terminal to negative terminal through the lamp. Hence lamp is on. It is observed by the lamp condition. If lamp is on, current will flow. If lamp is off, there is no flow of current. As per the Ohm's law, this magnitude of current flowing through the conductor is directly proportional to voltage or potential difference across the ends. If I is the current flowing through and V is the volts, hence I is directly proportional to V, or V by I is a constant. V by I is a constant. This constant is termed as resistance. Resistance R equal to V by I ohms. The resistance is measured in ohms. V voltage, it is expressed in volts. Current I, it is expressed in amperes. Thank you.